All right, everybody, in this video, I'm going to show you how to make an indicator of how far away you are from something or to something on the screen. If you haven't already seen the tutorial just before this one on how to show stuff on the screen, I'm going to link to that below because we're not going to cover all that. We're just going to cover the basic way to show distance based off of just the X and Y, so not the Z. So it's a little bit different than the only ups. We're going to be only outs. On the ground. So let's get into it. Okay, so here we are inside of UEFN, and I've got just a basic map as covered in the last tutorial. I've got my player spawner here, and I've got my game manager device right here. Now, the game manager is our verse code, so let's open up that by double-clicking in our creative devices here, which should open up our code. Inside of here, we want a way to tell the game to show us how far we are from a thing. And I'm going to use the player spawner device itself as the position to show how far away we are from it. So the first thing we need to do is make it an editable because we want to access it from the code. So an editable item allows us to set thing in the game available to our verse code. So I'm going to call this PSP. It is a player spawner device. Right here, you can see that. And that equals player spawner device. And squiggly brackets. So this is how we can set up something inside of code to be accessible in the game. So just this alone is important. So we're going to save this. We're going to go verse, build verse code. When you do that and you select your game object here, over on the right is going to show the PSP, which is our, we define this variable name ourselves, and it's going to allow us to connect something up. Now, because it's a player spawner device, there's only one player spawner device in the game, it's going to show that in the list. But if you wanted to, you could use this little eyedropper and pick the player spawner device here, or just pick it inside of here. No problem, either way. So now that we've connected up our player spawner device, once we've set it up to use this player spawner device inside of our game manager, we can go back to our verse code and we're all done with that part. So now we have access to that because we want to know where it is in comparison to us. So inside of the code, down inside of the onBegin, we've got our player sorting out where, who, which player do we want? We want the first one, and we've added a widget to the screen. Now we want to do a loop. There is a better way to do this, but I'm going to show you the most basic way to get this done is to run this for a one player game. Otherwise, we could attach it to the player object itself, but that sort of gets involved. I don't want to get into that in this tutorial. So we're just going to learn the basic code on how to make this happen. We're doing a loop. Loops are fantastic. They just go over and over and over again. And we're going to do sleep 0.1. So sleep is a way to pause our code briefly. 0.01 is 10% of a second, essentially. And then from there, we're going to have some code run every 0.1 of a second, essentially, as long as the server tick is 1 second each time, which it should be. Okay, so the player position variable is our position. Now, that's our Fortnite character that we got way up here. We're going to get the transform. The transform is the location of the character in the game, and we're going to grab the translation of that. So this is just something you have to remember. If you want to get the position of your character or anything, actually, we're going to grab the translation. So we're going to grab the PSP, which is the player spawn device. So I've called it that, without the Z. And we're going to make it into a vector 3. Vector 3 just means X, Y, Z. It's a vector-based object. So we've got the X, which is the player spawn position. X, the Y is going to be the player spawn position Y, and the Z is just going to be 0. And then for the player, we're going to get the player position, X, Y, and Z is going to be 0. Because we don't want to know if we're going up or down. We just want to know our distance across the map. So we could be going up or down. It just doesn't matter. And so that's how we get both the position of the player and this spawn device. Okay? Now, we want to know the horizontal distance, right? The distance from the spawn device to the player, and that is using the distance method. And we're going to first put in the Z less PSP, which is the player spawn without Z, and the player position, without z as the second argument in there. And then we divide that by 100 because it comes back in centimeters, but we want to make it into meters. So we want to know how many meters. You could do centimeters if you really want to. And then we're going to round it downwards. So we use the floor method, and that's going to get rid of it from being a float into an int, which is an integer. So we do that as an if because it's an optional. And then because we already did our distance text block item up here, we can reference that right here and set the text of that using our string to message again. Rounded distance in squiggly brackets. So that's the number that is done by code. That's the number that's calculated in code. And we want to put it into a string. So we put it inside of squiggly brackets and then meters. And you're done. That's it. It's really that simple. Hopefully that makes a lot of sense. It's the logic is simple. We want to know where the spawn device is. We want to know where the player is. We use the distance method within the spatial math to sort out the distance between those two. Divided by 100, show it on the screen. We already know how to show stuff on the screen in the past tutorial. And that's how you do it here to show something that's going to update often. Hopefully that's been a little bit interesting. And we're all done for this one. Nice and easy. I'll see you guys in the next one.